Hey, what's up everybody? So, quick introduction. This is a Venusaur moveset. I have four different movesets on this video. Two of them are fairly common, and two of them I don't really see too often. They are two of my own sets. I don't know if they've been used before or not. I'm going to go ahead and show you guys anyways. So, here we go. First off is my number three set, which is, Venusaur's nickname because he's the third Pokemon and it's kind of a kids next door reference. Anyways, getting into the set. It's a comm set, it's a special defensive wall. You can either run Overgrow or Chlorophyll, doesn't really matter, but seeing as he's a special wall, I tend to use Overgrow more because I tend to use him on the rain teams because it kind of takes down the attacks from fire moves, so that's pretty nice. So, you're gonna want to run 252 HP EVs and obviously the 252 special defense EVs. The other four EVs don't really matter. If you want to put them in defense, go ahead, but I usually put them in special attack because he does have some special attacking moves. Now, I kind of needed to put Black Sludge on most of these things. I kind of screwed up on that because my mindset was on leftovers for recovery. If you kind of rather use leftovers, go right ahead. Black Sludge does work as well. I prefer Black Sludge. So his moveset is Leech Seed, Gage Drain, Sludge Bomb, Protect. And if you decide to use it on a Chlorophyll, you might want to run Sleep Powder because you can outspeed something and put it to sleep. But I run Protect, and I'll show you guys later on why I tend to run Protect over anything else. But it's a pretty much a Leech Seed stalling kind of thing. Sludge Bomb is there for some nice damage, and there is a slight possibility of poisoning the Pokemon, so that is always nice. And Giga Drain is for helping you get your HP back up. So with Leech Seed, Giga Drain, and Protect all working together, you're getting your health risen a lot with leftovers or Black Sludge. So that's really nice. Now the next set is a Swords Dancing Venusaur. I call it the Dancing Venusaur. It's an adamant nature, I guess, whatever. You can run this with Overgrow or Chlorophyll, doesn't really matter. I use Overgrow because I use this set without a fire team, fire-based, sun team. But you can either put his HP EVs into 4 or 252, whether or not you want a bulky variation of this. And attack is always going to be 252 because you're going to be Swords Dancing. I guess you could split up the EVs in some kind of weird order, but this is how I tend to do it. And speed can either be 252 or 4. I put that as that because if you want a bulkier variation, you might as well just run the 4 EVs in speed, and if you want a faster one, you might want to just run the 4 EVs in HP. Again, leftovers or Black Sludge is fine. I prefer Black Sludge. So here we go. Dancing Venusaur is Swords Dance, Double-Edged or Sleep Powder. Now I usually run used to run it on PO Sleep Powder because Sleep Powder you can put something to sleep then start setting up on it. But the only problem is that Venusaur is obviously in OU and there are pretty nice counters to him, not having Hidden Power Fire and everything. So that might help you, and you just have to pretty much take care of like things like Skarmory out of the way before bringing in this Venusaur. But his attacks are Seed Bomb, Earthquake, and if you don't want to run Sleep Powder, then you can run the Double Edge. But Sleep Powder stab very nice with the Swords Dance. I run Swords Dance over anything because if you decide to do put this on a Sun team, you can always use Swords Dance to get a +2. Whereas if you're in the middle of a weather war, you might have the possibility of them bringing something in on you while you use Growth and you only go up one stage. And then Earthquake is, anything that kind of resists the Seed Bomb can get hit by it, like Fire types or the Steel types. Now, this is the last set. This is a very fairly common set used by most OU tiers users. And it's a Chlorophyll Venusaur with the nature Adamant or Modest, because this is where they split up. And the ability Chlorophyll, this is very, commonly used. The special IV spread is Hidden Power Fire. I put that down there for you guys. That's only for the special attacking one. Obviously, you're going to want to run 252 speed in the sun. I guess you could run in HP, and then Chlorophyll can boost your speed. That's what I usually do, but this is just the common set, kind of, from what I've seen. I put 4 EVs in HP because just where else are you going to put it? He's got really nice physical natural bulk and a really nice special defensive bulk. I can't think of the word. Anyways, going on, and his attack or special attack should be 252 EVs. Now, again, like I said, the special one is on the right, and the physical one's on the left. And like I said before, I run Swords Dance Overgrowth because if you're gonna run a physical one, I mean, you could run a mixed one, but I don't really do that. I kind of stick to one thing so that way my things can go up. But anyways, I'm gonna run Swords Dance Overgrowth because, like I said before, Weather War shit, shenanigans and whatever. So Double Edge is to hit anything like flying type Pokemon that you really can't hit with the Seed Bomb or the Earthquake. Maybe Tornadus because that did move up to the OU tier. Earthquake, you know, hit the things that Double Edge and Seed Bomb really can't do very effective damage on. And Seed Bomb just to, you know, have the stab and take care of some water type Pokemon. And on the special set, you're going to run Growth, and it's going to obviously have to be in the sun to use it. And it's going to run Solar Beam because Solar Beam is only going to be one turn in the sun, so make sure you definitely run this in the sun. Sludge Bomb or Giga Drain. I put or Giga Drain because this is a Life Orb set. I kind of forgot to say that before. But actually, I don't know if I put it in. Let me just go check really quick. Yes, I did. Or you could run Leftovers. But Giga Drain is if you really just want to gain a little bit of health back because you're slowly going down with your HP with the Life Orb. But it kind of is like a mid late game sweeper, so it doesn't really matter too much because you're going to be outspeeding things and taking things down. So that's why I put Sludge Bomb first, because Sludge Bomb is stab, and it is very nice to just have in case, like, you don't run Hidden Power Ice, for example, because that can hit a Dragonite with neutral damage and it's stab, and you have a growth added to it. So that'll do a nice amount of damage. And if you run the 252 EVs in speed, you should be able to outspeed Dragonite after 1 DD. I'm not too sure about that. I'm just going to make a nice guess on that. You should probably be faster. And if not, maybe you want to run a Timid set. I don't know what to tell you. But anyways, you can run Hidden Power Fire, which I would prefer on this set because it is fire, sun boosted, and you know it can hit Ferrothorns, which the other two moves really can't hit. Or you can run the Hidden Power Ice and take care of Dragon types. It's your set. I don't know, run how you want it, but go ahead and yeah. So let me just get this out here now, and I have put together some clips for you guys, and I'll walk you through them. So right here, I wanted to show that I used this on my rain team, which, you know, Politoed being over there, and then showing a Venusaur right there. So we can see this video pretty much based on Infernape and Landorus with Venusaur, and I don't know why this video is actually taking this long. Sorry about this. I just kind of put this clip together, and yeah. So as you can see, I switch out with my Bulldozer because I know he's going to go for a Will-O-Wisp. And Venusaur, special attacking wall, doesn't mind getting a burn. So he's going to go for a burn here, which really is just stupid. I'm going to go for Leech Seed. I'm going to get some HP back from this and pretty much be at whatever. But he's going to go for Shadow Sneak here. Now, I went for Leech Seed because I kind of thought, you know, when people tend to get Leech Seeded, they tend to switch out just because they don't want their Pokemon getting more Leech Seed done. But right here, he's actually going to switch out, and I go in for the Protect, I believe. No, I just go for the Giga Drain to see which kind of set he is, and if he was Special Defensive, that's fine. But I hit the Landers on the switch, and that's a neutral hit, and it does this amount, and it gives me up HP. So he goes for a U-turn. I don't know if that's Scarf or Choice Banner or what, but look how well he takes it. It is a neutral hit because of the Poison typing on the Grass type, so yeah. So he's going to bring in Infernape here, so I know he's not going to go for a Fire move. So I'm just going to Protect to see actually what he want to do. He goes for the Hidden Power. I'm guessing it's Hidden Power Ice. And right here, he's going to go for the Close Combat. I guess predicting me to switch out, I meant to put something up. I don't know. But that's in the video. And I'm just going to go for a Sludge Bomb, which is a clean one-hit KO on this Infernape with, you know, not really investing too much in special attack either. So right here he's just going to go into his Landorus. I kind of wanted to burn stall him out so that way, so I knew he was going to U-turn and he was locked into it. I just really wanted his Landorus being in so I could bring in something, but I'm just going to faint with the next Protect, which does kind of suck. But yeah, here's the second thing. It's in 4th gen. He is a pretty nice thing to run in 4th gen UU, actually. So is Blaziken, but that's a different story. But in 4th gen UU, Venusaur, that's his tier. It's not OU, so yeah. And, you know, being in UU, it gets some nice, you know, bulk and all that shenanigans going on. So yeah, so I'm going to bring in on a Fralgator who's going to go for a Crunch. Now, watch this. It barely does anything. I don't know what EVs or what, but he's going to get Defense Fall. Now, I'm like, alright. So, if this is a standard, you know, Fralgator's going to have, like, Ice Punch or something. So, I'm just going for a Giga Drain. I know it's not going to do too much because Fralgator has a natural, nice spec D. But it's actually going to do a little bit more than I expected. So, that. Then we're going to get back up to full HP. And he's going to go for Ice Fang. You know, obviously not Ice Punch, not as powerful. But look how well Venusaur can take a super effective hit after Defense Fall. That is pretty nice. I don't know the IVs and EVs run on this Fralgator, but I would assume that it's kind of, I don't know, but it takes it very nicely. That's what I wanted to say. So, yeah, I don't know why I have leftovers on it. I'm sorry, guys. I really mean to run Black Sludge. But anyways, you're bringing a Mewtwo here. He's going to go for a Rock Slide. This I don't know what this guy was battling with, whatever. Look, he takes a Rock Slide fairly well. Mewtwo doesn't have the worst attack set ever, so, you know, it is pretty whatever. So I just kind of stayed in as Death Fodder to see what he wanted to do. I thought I could take a Psychic, but who knows. I'm just going to go for a Protect here to show you guys how well the Protect Leech Seed stall can really work out. And, you know, with leftovers after the Leech Seed, right, we're going to be just above 300 HP. And, yeah, so he's going to go for a Psycho Cut. That's a physical hitting Mewtwo move. That's obviously going to KO because it's a Mewtwo. Come on, guys. It is a Mewtwo. It's Uber. But, you know, you don't have to worry about that and the tier you can use it in unless you decide to use an Ubers. So right here, the opposite Razor Ass one over there is the same exact set as my Venusaur. This is my cousin I was battling with. He had the same exact team as me. So, yeah. So he's going to go for a Protect, because he thought I was going to go for an Explosion, which, you know, that is a very nice, play, because if used in, 4th gen, if the other team, you know, has Pokemon with Explosion, you can, throw them off by leaving Venusaur in and protecting, but, you know, whatever. I'm just going to go for a Will-O-Wisp, because, you know, even though, Venusaur really doesn't mind taking it, it does, you know, wear down a Venusaur. But yeah, anyways, it doesn't really matter. He's going to go for a Leech Seed. He keeps missing. That's kind of sucks, but I'm going to go for Explosion here. This is what I really just wanted to show you guys. So I went for an Explosion, which is not nerfed in 4th gen. And look how well Venusaur took that. I mean, I know I'm not running any minus nature in physical attack on this set, I don't believe. But, you know, it did take it pretty well. But I'm just going to finish it off with an Earthquake right here. But, I mean, you know, Venusaur can take a few hits, and it can stall. And, well, not really stall, but it can pretty much wear down some kind of walls. Especially Melodic in UU and 4th gen. So I'm right here going to say I'm going to go for Leech Seed. That does, you know, a decent amount, seeing how this Melodic is running max HP. So, that does a pretty nice amount. And I'm going to Protect right here, because I know the Ice Beam is going to come, right? So, I'm going to get more Leech Seed and Leftovers, even though I am at full health. But, yeah. So, Melodic's running a couple EVs and Special Attack. And I take that pretty well. That's only about 104 damage. And I'm going to get about most of that back with the Giga Drain combo with Leech Seed and Leftovers. So, that's also pretty nice. So we're going to get back up to 305 HP, and then with Leftovers and Leech Seed, we should be at, like, actually, yeah, back at full. So it's like that Melodic's not really doing anything to me at all, and I'm just wearing it down. It went down to half health from, like 3 turns. I'm still at full health. So I'm going to go for a Giga Drain here on the incoming Azumarill. Azumarill is running max HP, so it's not going to be a one-hit KO. Azumarill does have a pretty nice natural bulk with the you know, HP risen all the way up, but I'm gonna go for another Giga Drain. Look, did you guys? Oh, I'm sorry, I outspeeded him, but he's gonna lock himself in on a choice banded super effective big power or huge power, I don't know which one it is, ice punch. And just look at this. I take that. I mean, it's not taken too well, but Venusaur can still take that. And that's not running any physical defense EVs whatsoever. And that's a very powerful move coming from an Azumarill. So I'm just going to go for the Gig Drain because I want to make sure the thing's gone so I can possibly, you know, take something from Melodic. I'm kind of downing it, but you never know. So right here, Melodic's going to come in. I'm going to go straight for the Protect. He's just going to waste the turn going for Ice Beam. Definitely try and get rid of Venusaur because you definitely don't want this Venusaur hanging around too long because it hanging out around kind of can screw up a wall, as you already saw. He's just going to go for the Ice Beam, and, you know, if I had a couple more health points left, I could have lived that, but I only had 102. So that's my clips, guys. Sorry it's not, you know, all the best ones. This is what I had to show, and I hope you guys enjoyed this set. It's a really nice set. I love using this set. I came up with it by myself. I had another match with it before. My opponent, Connor, kind of rage quitted on me because it was such a hoary set. But not really hoary, it's just amazing set, because I took like a +4 Ice Fang from a Gliscor, so yeah, and an Earthquake, so yeah, it's a pretty nice set. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.